In 1937, scientists cooled liquid helium-4 to just above absolute zero. They observed a new phase of matter, the superfluid, which flows like a fluid with zero viscosity.
Here you see the liquid passing into the superfluid phase.
In 1949, the future Nobel laureate Lars Onsager predicted that this frictionless behavior could be partly explained by a bizarre phenomenon, the formation of vortices, or microscopic quantum tornadoes.
That's really the fingerprint, I would say even the hallmark of superfluidity.
So there is a very simple picture to understand this. Imagine that you have a bucket. If you put a superfluid inside this bucket, if you rotate the bucket very slow, the superfluid would just stay at rest. It would not move at all. Then you exceed a critical velocity, and then the system has to respond in some way.
The rotation frequency is so large that the fluid inside cannot ignore anymore that something is happening. There is all this angular momentum that we are imposing. So instead of globally rotating, the superfluid creates a number of very small tornadoes.
These quantum tornadoes were also predicted to exist in the supersolid, an exotic phase of matter with both superfluid properties and a rigid solid structure.
You need to detect the two natures of the system. So you need to detect the solid part and the superfluid part.
We knew very well the importance of observing vortices.
To create these vortices, you need to put your system under rotation, but our supersolid state is quite fragile. And so we needed to find a good way to rotate the system without destroying it.
The Innsbruck team harnessed the magnetic properties of dysprosium atoms to steer their system.
Using lasers, we cool these atoms down to very close to the absolute zero. You can trap these atoms, and you have that the system behave as a whole single quantum wave.
The team steered the atom's internal magnetic field about 50 times a second, fast enough to generate vortices while preserving the delicate quantum phase.
And we saw the presence of these little holes. These are the vortices.
For the first time, they observed the dual nature of a supersolid.
It was producing exactly the same images as the simulation.
They were really able to observe it, and this was a big result.